Hello, and welcome to this YFA Pro Tip. My name is Charlene Erickson, and today I'm going to talk about the miscoordinated fault transfer setting and demonstrate a real-world example from one of our customers. So this is the setting that I'm referring to, that is the miscoordinated fault transfer. This is a customer site that I renamed so that I won't give away all their secrets. They do have the miscoordinated fault transfers disabled. And they had a real event where they had a fault downstream from W3. And then that fault out in the field caused some conductors to slap together, and that tripped CB15 up here in the substation. So both of these devices locked out. And because they did not have any miscoordinated fault transfers enabled, they had a larger outage than they might have otherwise. So that's what we're going to show today. First thing I did was I created a script. I'm just going to flash this up here on the screen. You can pause the video if you want to take a closer look at it. So I'm going to go to my manager, and I'm going to open up the simulator application. And the first thing I'm going to do is load in this script. And then I'm going to hit play. And then we can watch. First thing I put in the script is just some reset stuff. So if I want to run it multiple times, it will take care of resetting everything for me. Then I set the load current on the transformers a little lower so that I don't have any load capacity issues when it goes to reconfigure, making sure that all the feeders are enabled. And then we put the fault on. So what we see here is that we opened up W1 and opened up W2 to isolate that section, and then closed in the tie point to re-energize these two zones over here. So if we want to look at the logs for this miscoordinated fault, we can see that YFA sees that it is a miscoordinated fault. If we look at this one, the downstream fault was already processed because it's on a single zone that's already isolated next to the tie point. And we know it's a miscoordination problem. However, we cannot close any of the switching devices because miscoordinated fault transfer is disabled. So what we do is we check to see if any of the downstream devices saw the fault. We see W1 did see it, but we're going to open it up because we're going to isolate around that zone as well. So then we open up W2 to isolate, and then we evaluate our reconnect options and close in tie WX2. So the question is, why did we open that up? And that is related to the miscoordinated fault transfer. If I put my mouse over this setting, you'll see the tooltip pop up. And the key sentence is in the second paragraph. It says, when disabled, the system will not close any locked out device and will isolate all zones where a fault was detected. So because W1 also enunciated that it saw the fault, because it's upstream from this device with the fault, YFA says, well, I don't know where the fault is, and you don't want me to transfer from miscoordinated fault, so I'm going to isolate all three of these zones. Did exactly what it was supposed to do. Now, what happens if we change this setting? So we enable the miscoordinated fault transfer, and I save it, and I need to restart YFA with that new setting. We can go back to our simulator window. The script should still be loaded, but just in case, I'll load it up again. Once everything is started, we can go ahead and run our script again. And then we can watch the logs to see what YFA does this time. Now we see this time, YFA closed in that circuit breaker 15 to restore power because it transferred the miscoordinated fault. And we can see that in the logs. Here is the start of the fault. New information, miscoordinated fault detected. So the downstream fault was already processed. We're going to assume it's a miscoordination problem. We're going to reset the fault targets, then we're going to close in that upstream device. We issue the close request to circuit breaker 15 and verify it's closed. So I hope you found this pro tip useful today and learned something. Thank you for watching.